really pleased to have you here for another year.
Es para nosotros un auténtico placer pues que hayáis decidido venir a Guardamar pues a conocer el municipio y aprender también el idioma. Que
it's a real pleasure for us that you have chosen Guardamar to know us better and to learn the Spanish language.
Sería importante que no necesitan la traducción.
It would be really nice if you did not need the translator. Pero ya han empezado a hablar este año. Yo tu primer contacto con el castellano ha sido aquí. You started now in Spanish. You started now in learning Spanish.
Your first time.
First time.
Okay. Y bien, pues encantado que estéis aquí y vamos a entregar otros diplomas.
Andrés, déjame decirte una palabra.
Claro.
Déjame decir a few words.
Well,
you can speak in Norwegian if you want, or in Spanish, in English, and I'll translate for you.
Don't worry, I have some
trouble. Norwegian?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, but he speaks English.
No, only English.
Alcalde José Luis, sí. Manager of the tourist office, Juan Carlos, students of Spanish classes. It's always a pleasure for my wife and me to come to the town hall. We are not big. But next year we will have had more than 10,000 nights in Guardamar, which means 10,000 breakfasts, 10,000 lunches, 30,000 meals. And anyone can guess how many glass of wine.
Y no te puedes imaginar cuántos vasos.
Me lo puedo imaginar.
And I don't know how it is in Spain. In Norway, somebody who studies there will get their diploma in the town hall.
Que para que alguien allí estudie. Creo que normalmente que consigue su diploma de manos del alcalde. En Norway se estila entre los policías, las enfermeras, los manos del alcalde, por ejemplo.
I'm an economist. I got this by post.
Yo soy economista y a mí lo enviaron por correo.
But the students of Utenostian,
pero los
who are studying here,
que estudian aquí,
they will get a diploma in the town hall.
Van a conseguir su diploma en el ayuntamiento.
By alcalde José Luis Sáez Pastor.
Muy bien.
By himself. Isn't that great?
Okay. I will call you and I will give it to them there. Excuse me my Norwegian pronunciation, I will do my best. Amalie Norgard. Not too bad.
Congratulations.
Randy Stangeland. I'm an English.
Congratulations. How many you have?
Doce.
I remember last year.
Yeah.
You have the 2 years ago. Last year.
Yes.
You have 12.
Yes.
Okay. Congratulations.
Cecil Staff.
I'm going to talk to German.
French.
French. Muy bien.
Linda Helen Andersen.
Congratulations. Muy bien.
It's in Gothic, it's not my fault. I don't know, but it's in Gothic. Bente Almas? How do you pronounce that?
Bente.
Yeah? Not Helen.
No, Bente? Bente? Bente?
Bente? Bente. Bente. Your surname? How do you pronounce it in Norwegian?
Bente.
Almas. And your family?
Almas.
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 Almas. In Spain we are, you know, we are, and you know there's tú and usted, but in Spain we use a lot tú. Usted is only for very formal occasions. Some regions are different, but in general we tend to speak tú. We speak usted with older people and with people of high respect, you know what I mean? But the children nowadays, they speak tú.
Thank you. Bueno, pues que aprovechéis los días que os quedan hasta el próximo sábado.
Take advantage of your last few days until Saturday.
Como veis, en Guadamar siempre hay sol.
There's always sun in Guadamar. Sunshine.
I pay more money for the sun here.
Yes, we pay special taxes to God.
Yeah. Y nada, encantado de haberos ofrecido el diploma y espero que os
guste. And it was really nice to be able to give you your diploma.
I see you the next year.